Hi fish lovers, welcome to my channel, Ornamental Fish Farming. So guys, today I'm going to tell you about molly fish, one of the best fish for beginners. Molly fish, or just mollies, are freshwater fish from the genus Poecilia in the Poeciliidae family. These fish are native to the Americas, but their habitat can vary significantly. They are a very popular group of fish. Most species are hardy and easy to care for, making them great for beginners. They work well in peaceful community aquariums. If kept in a healthy environment, a group of mollies will thrive and can live up to 5 years. They are a peaceful bunch most of the time but can show signs of aggression when crowded or surrounded by aggressive tank mates. Therefore, it's important that their tank is big enough and that they have suitable tank mates. There are lots of molly fish varieties. The main differences are colors and patterns, and sizes and shapes can differ too. Common black molly, Dalmatian molly, Dalmatian lyretail molly, black sailfin molly, white silver sailfin molly, black lyretail molly, balloon belly molly, gold doubloon molly, harlequin sailfin molly, platinum lyretail molly, golden sailfin molly, wild molly fish. Sexual maturity and male-female difference. An interesting experience to know the molly fish gender. Firstly, make sure that mollies are mature enough in order to identify their gender, because mollies usually don't display gender at an early age. Let the molly fish fry grown up to mature fish for at least a few months. After, when they reach the age of maturity, you can identify their gender on the base of 5 signs. Number 1. Color. Male mollies usually acquire bolder and brighter color patterns than the female mollies. Female mollies have dull, timid, and demure color schemes. That's why the bolder color variations of male mollies seem to be attractive. It also attracts female mollies towards mating. Number 2. Size and shape. Male mollies are mostly larger in size than females. Female mollies usually have a rounded body, especially abdomen, while the male mollies have a flat body shape. Number 3. Dorsal fin. Dorsal fin is the back fin of mollies. Male and female mollies both have a dorsal fin, but the male mollies usually have a larger dorsal fin than females. Male's larger dorsal fin also enhances their beauty and often helps to attract the female for mating. Number 4. Anal fin. The other features might vary from species, but anal fin is the most specific part used to identify the gender. Anal fin is the present underside, behind the belly. The size of the anal fin in males is usually larger or longer in size than the females. Male's anal fin of molly fish is modified into the tube-like shape, which is called gonopodium, through which they copulate with the female molly. While the female's anal fin has a triangular shape. Number 5. Behavior. The gender of mollies can also be identified by noticing their behavior. Male mollies are attention seekers. They always try to catch female mollies' attention in order to mate with them. They continue to chase females and swim in front of them, showing their fin to attain the attention. If you notice a fish doing such things, you can strongly comment that this is the male molly and is trying to mate with the female. Tank requirements. A molly fish needs at least a 10-gallon aquarium. This size would be depending on the species. Larger mollies like the sailfin will need a 30-gallon tank. Each additional molly will need around 3 gallons to live comfortably. A tropical fish like this needs a heater in the tank to maintain temperatures of 72 to 78 degrees Fahrenheit. Keep pH between 6.7 and 8.5 and hardness between 20 to 30 kilohenries. Tank mates. As peaceful fish, they don't cause many problems, so they go great with other peaceful species in a community aquarium. Some good choices include cherry barbs, Corydoras catfish, Danios, dwarf gourami, harlequin rusbra, platys, rosy barbs, tetras, yo-yo loaches, and zebra loaches. There are lots more to choose from. Most small peaceful community fish will be fine. Fish to avoid are large or aggressive. Large fish will try to eat your mollies. Aggressive ones may attack and stress them out to the point of death. As an example, cichlids. Food. As omnivores, there are lots of different food types that you can feed them. Algae is a big part of their diet. They use their lips to scrape it from surfaces. Vegetation is important too. You can use small pieces of green vegetables from your kitchen. Lettuce, spinach, and zucchini are all good options to drop into your aquarium. Artificial foods like flakes and pellets are an easy option. Try to supplement these with other foods to provide a wide range of nutrients. Live and frozen foods are excellent sources of protein. Bloodworms and brine shrimp will be happily accepted, but most other options work well too. Live foods are more interesting for the fish come feeding time too. Feed them small amounts twice a day. This gives their digestive system a chance to process the food. Give them as much as they can finish in 2 minutes. Breeding of molly fish. Mollies are live bearers, which means their eggs develop inside their body so that live fry can be released. They are one of the easiest fish groups to breed in captivity and will mate regularly. Raising the temperature slightly could help to initiate mating, but don't go higher than 78 degrees Fahrenheit. Males perform a courting display for the females. When the female is ready to mate, she will allow the male to fertilize her eggs. Sometimes the male tries to sneak copulate, where he approaches an unaware female from behind. Females often choose to mate with the largest males. And guppies and mollies can also breed with each other. After fertilization, it will take 35 to 45 days before the young are released. Larger females could release up to 100 juveniles. The young need to be separated from the adults or they will get eaten. One option is to put pregnant mollies in a breeder's box before they give birth. The young are free to leave the box through small holes, but the adults stay trapped. You can feed them foods like broken flakes or live feed until they're big enough to eat the same foods as the adults. At this point, they can be mixed back in with them. Thank you for watching my video. Please like and subscribe to my channel and click the bell icon. You will never miss the new videos. If you have a question, don't forget to comment. So see you in my next video.